Hi, and welcome to another weekly B2CRM news highlights, the home of bite-sized insights for the B2C CRM marketeer. Now, this time, we're going to focus on one story, the John Oliver versus Pringles story. And we're going to start with the timeline. The video I'm going to show you now is from November 8th, back when millions of people were waiting for the US presidential results to come in. Back then, Oliver made a joke about how CNN's Don Lemon, that you see here on the left, was pestering a man with questions about when the election results would come in that he did not have the answers to. And Oliver responded like this.
Speaking of, that was a good answer, but are you talking hours? Are you talking days?
He doesn't fucking know, Lemon. Leave the man alone. At that point, it would have been just as productive to ask him, when will penguins learn how to fly? Or when is Michael Keaton going to win an Oscar? Or what does the rest of the Pringle guy's body look like? Is he tall or short? Does he have a lot of body hair? Or is he completely smooth? When will you be able to tell me what his nipples look like? Are you talking hours or are you talking days? What was all...
So, a couple of weeks later, last week, tonight's season ended and the world kept turning. Then, last week, we saw these press releases about how Pringles is going to change its cans and the mascot's design for the first time in 20 years. The mascot's name, by the way, is Julius. It's Julius Pringles. But still here, we did not suspect anything. Then, this past Sunday, Mr. Oliver popped up on our YouTube notifications again with a special 5-minute clip about how viewers responded to the question regarding Julius's body. In the video, he showed drawings by viewers. They posted them on social media, suggesting how Pringles' body should look like. And then at the end of the video, he presented Pringles with a challenge, and one that they could apparently not refuse.
My point here is, I know so much useless information about Pringles, but not the one thing that I really want to know, which is, what is Julius Pringles working with from the neck down? Do I need to know this? No, I don't. Do I want to? Yes, very badly. So much so that I'm willing to give $10,000 to Feeding America if Pringles answers my question, on the condition, of course, that they don't spend a fucking penny of that money on Pringles, because it's a garbage snack. It's garbage. The ball is in your court, guys. The choice is yours. Do the right Pring here. Thank
you. All right. Even here, we must admit we did not connect the dots yet. But then, this morning, Pringles, on social media, on Twitter, announced that they will present Julius Pringles' body today, December 8th, and essentially dropping the penny for us. Because, yes, the timing of it all is amazing, but is it truly just a coincidence, just plain luck, which Pringles also acted very quickly on? Or is it an unmarked influencer campaign? A very brave and sophisticated one, given the fact that he called it a garbage snack or whatnot. Now, we don't know. What we do know is that we do not believe in coincidences, but we also love brilliant marketing campaigns. And that's it for this week.